Hi, hello everybody. Welcome back to part 3 of my Sekiro Shadows Die Twice playthrough. Without further ado, let's get into it. I want to thank all my supporters. You know, you guys are great. Help my name get out there. Share, subscribe, like, do all that good stuff, and I'm just gonna keep plugging along, making great content for y'all. So without further ado, let's get into this Sekiro Shadows Die Twice part 3. I guess it's kind of a walkthrough. I know a lot about this game. I've platinumed it, so one of my favorite gaming companies, as I said before, is FromSoft. They've got excellent quality in their games. Alright, I'm just gonna hit continue. I do believe I was at the Hirata Estate, in the fiery area, so we're going to continue that area. Just keep plugging along, you know what I'm saying? Alright, so we'll go this way. I don't think there was anything that's where I came from. So we run over here, mark this guy. Buddies don't know. And then we come up here, we sneak along the roof. True ninja. You know what? Heck it. What's up? Archer's gonna make me mad, man. I'm gonna have to retreat. Heal. Jump over this guy. This archer's gonna get it. Take everybody else out but the archer. Come on, bro. Do your little stabby attack. You need some distance. Come on. That Makiri counter, boy. Alright. For some reason, I think I should have had more gourd seeds by now. Maybe that's what I'm about to go get. A second. I know there's one up further. I'm just thinking about where I went before I next boss fight. Divine confetti that comes in handy when fighting a certain type of enemy later. So what we do for this next area, is if we got all these guys killed, is there's a dude that'll help you out, Inosuke. I'm pretty sure his name's Inosuke. He helps you out with this next boss fight. He's standing right there. That guy in the blue right there, I don't know if you see him past the grass. He'll help you fight all those dudes, but what we're gonna wanna do is clear out part of them. Because if not, hello who's ever watching, I appreciate you. Because if we don't clear out these dudes, then they'll just kill them really quick. So before we fight the boss, we're gonna jump up in here, do a little bit of hunting. Shut your mouth. Let's see what else is. I think we come up over here and I can get the drop on one of these dudes right here. All right. right. Come on, then. Damn it, Juzo. That's what I was waiting for. How does that poison not affect his own guys? That's so... Alright, now what we do with this guy is we lead him over this way. Oh, you're lucky I missed. Best thing for him, I do believe, is either gonna be the fire or the axe. There's no way to get a jump stab on him, but I'm gonna get this guy's help right here, so there's two of us. Oh no. Ugh. And if ever you need to back up for a second, you hold down your block button, you'll regain your posture super quick. Here we go. Alright, there's the first death stab. Or shinobi death blow, I mean. Kill that dude? Oh. There we go. There it is, unrefined sake, bottle of cloudy sake, unrefined. Sake is a drink meant for sharing. This cloudy sake is one of Ishin Ashina's favorites. It has a rich, full body flavor. On the other hand, it has a reputation for getting one too drunk too quickly. Prayer bead. All right, I have three prayer beads now. All right, thank you for the help, homie.
That fight was hard.
You don't seem too old, but...
Go on ahead.
Alright, I will. Thank you for the help. Hella appreciate it, bro. Hella appreciate it, bro. There's some dudes down here. If I'm not... mistaken. This is where I get one of my... prayer beads, though. So I need to... It's either a prayer bead or... Or it's a... gourd seed. Either one is useful. Honestly, I could care less if it's either or. I think it's a gourd seed, actually. Now that I'm thinking about it. But you just hug this wall. Brings you... around, a boo balloon of wealth, light coin purse, smack this. It should be in here. Prayer bead, awesome. It is a prayer bead. Alright, so before we go fight Lady Butterfly, which it will be the next boss fight, we're going to continue on in the other area first. That'll give us more power, more stamina, more vitality, and possibly another prayer bead or two for the fight with Lady Butterfly, which you're going to want. She can be tough. What she's talking about here is actually once you die, something, I forget what it's called, it'll explain it later. Once you die, stagnation overflows is what they say. And that stagnation causes sickness. The sickness, which spreads, and it's known as dragon rot if you die too much. And this will kill off some NPCs if you don't take care of it. So that's why it's best not to die a bunch. I'm gonna rest. I am going to acquire skills. And I am going to go to that other area. So Fang and Blade or Nightjar Slash. Nightjar Slash is okay. I'm gonna save up for a minute. Our prosthetic tool, though, that's gonna be better. All right, so enhance our physical attributes with the 4 prayer beads. Consume them. Yes. All right. First prayer bead necklace. Loose prayer beads strung together in offering to sculptor's idol increases maximum vitality and posture. Prayer bead necklace befits the strong. The ferocity of Ashina's army is renowned throughout the nation. Its generals, especially talented, every one of them accomplished in the Ashina sword style. They're tough opponents. Like the general that I fought before I bought the firecracker in earlier episodes. He was a tough opponent. If I didn't get that jump stab on him, the first death blow, he would have definitely done some damage. It would have been a harder fight. Alright, now we're gonna travel to the dilapidated temple. I do believe I haven't put the feather in yet, and gotten that as a prosthetic tool, but it's a pretty cool prosthetic tool. Also, I'm going to show you guys one dude over here, too, that you can practice on. And he helps with learning how to do the Makiri counter, how to do deflections, how to block, how to do a few different things. So, all right, we'll fit this Mistraven feather in. All right, got that.
No matter what I do. Thus is the fate of those who owe it. You will understand when so.
I'm gonna show you guys this dude over here. Do I have any more? Did I find any more?
Yes.
Like what?
I died. The divine heir's voice reached out to me, and suddenly I was alive again. Gourd
seeds, but...
So you died, and now you're alive again. So that means it has to do with resurrection.
Resurrection?
Lord Kuro. It's said to be a power of the Divine Heir's dragon heritage. Those who have been given the power of resurrection, they are revived upon death, repeatedly.
Impossible.
Yes. It is rather strange. And yet, it is happening here and now. Let me know if you notice any more changes.
I just want to see if I have any gourd seeds.
Resurrection comes without a cost.
Stagnation overflows, like I said. I don't have any gourd seeds. Okay. So what we're going to do is I'm going to show you guys really quick. This dude up here, he's Hanbei the Undying. You can practice your moves on him. You'll see.
Your name? But you do have the look of a skilled shinobi. A shinobi. Hmm. Sir, please heed my humble request. Face me in battle.
He's infested.
Damn.
Can't die.
Still alive.
Surprised? Is it something like me? Or is it something else? You guys will see. Keep watching in order to find out.
You have managed to kill me in such a thorough manner.
What are you?
Some call it undying. Others, infested. I can't die, so I just am. How about you? What brings you to a rundown temple like this? Seems you have a lot on your mind. Say, you use me for some sword practice. Might come in handy for whatever your mission is. A warm body that can't die might prove useful to you. I volunteer mine.
Well, what a nice guy. Except. Well.
Right then, they say.
Alright, so this guy does training. Okay. I'm gonna do attacks. A shinobi aims to break the opponent's posture. Attacking an enemy is one way to achieve this. An enemy with broken posture is vulnerable to a shinobi death blow. Performing three death blows after breaking enemy posture. R1 to attack, R1 after enemy breaking posture to death blow. So you just basically gotta sit there and attack him until you get a death blow. This is one way to practice your all kinds of stuff. So he'll teach you about step dodges, stabs, stuff like that, and how to counter thrust attacks and all that good stuff. I'll show you the Mikiri counter training, deflect, step dodge. We'll do that one. So a shinobi can perceive incoming thrust attacks and counter them by stepping on the enemy's blade. It is known as a Mikiri counter. This move is powerful if risky, but it deals more posture damage than regular deflect. Use Mikiri counter to perform three death blows. You dodge forward into him when he does that. You gotta get the timing right though. Luckily I've played the game quite a few times. I know how to do the Mikiri counter, so. Deflects. Sometimes relentless attack is not enough to break an enemy's posture. Deflecting an enemy's attack also damages their posture, and a master of shinobi will both deflect and attack. Deflecting enemy attacks will perform three death blows. L1 the moment an attack lands to deflect, and R1 after breaking posture to perform a death blow. Ow.
Face me again.
Rhythm-based combat, love it. Step dodge allows one to avoid attacks. Dodging won't compromise enemy posture, but it may help avoid damage. Evade enemy attacks, then attack, and perform three death blows. Step dodge is circle. After dodging, R1, dodge counterattack. I'll show you guys. That's a step dodge. So he'll come try to do that, dodge really quick, and I'll let him center himself because he just keeps attacking. Dodge and attack, and it's really heavy posture damage once you're dealing damage to him too. Ow, I dodged too late. Okay. I already know how to do it. I was just showing you guys. So I think that's it. Maybe he...
About our training.
Oh.
I think it's about time we tried something closer to a real fight. Don't you? Come at me with the intent to kill. No better way to prepare. What's wrong?
Why do you go to such lengths?
Half to pass the time. And the other half. Well, I want to loosen that furrowed brow of yours. Alright. Enough talk. Let's begin.
Free combat is now available.
Now.
Fundamentals. Yes. That was a step dodge. Those stab attacks, they become important because you can't. The only thing an enemy can do is either parry. So if they're just sitting there blocking, you can do a stab attack and it'll get through. But if they can parry it, or they can Makiri counter if they're a ninja. You guys will see more on that later. But all right, consecutive deflections. That was three taps of L1. Sometimes they'll just keep attacking and you have to do that. Training, alright, vitality and posture. Sorry, I didn't let you guys read the last one. Alright, the lower one's vitality, the slower their posture recovers. For enemies with seemingly unbreakable posture, use techniques such as dodge. Counterattacks reduces their vitality, making their posture easier to break. Perform 3 death blows on the enemy. Step dodge and R1 after dodge to counterattack. So... once you bring their health down to 0, they get vulnerable to a death blow too. Focus on breaking posture and performing a death blow. Death. Shinobi. Shinobi, son. Alright. Countering thrust attacks.
I stand as your opponent.
This is where that Makiri counter comes in handy. You can also step dodge or press deflect it. You can't block it though. So, I'll deflect it. And then this time I'll step dodge it. And if he makes me do it again, it's Makiri counter time. Makiri counter is so much more effective, but it's dangerous. Dodging into the enemy is scary, to say the least. Countering sweep attacks. Sweep attacks cannot be guarded or deflected. They must be jumped over to be avoided. Jump kicking an enemy during a sweep attack deals heavy posture damage, often leading directly into a death blow. Counter sweep attacks to perform 3 death blows. Jump and jump in midair. Let's go, son. Sup? There's all kinds of sweeping attacks. Sometimes the best way to beat an enemy is to fight them over and over and over and learn their pattern. That's what I did in the beginning when I first started this game. And then that's why I'm so good at it now, is because obviously I've done it so much. We'll continue on with the story for now. I just wanted to show you guys all that training stuff. I'm going to rest. I'm going to travel to the Ashina stairway. And we're going to fight that big ogre. Hopefully, maybe get another gourd seed somewhere. I don't remember where all the gourd seeds are, is the problem. I know you can get 8 in the regular story, and there's a secret part of the story later that you can unlock. Let me see if I can buy anything from him. Nope. I'm gonna go back and probably try to buy another couple coin purses, because just in case this ogre, he's tough. He deals a lot of damage, just in case he decides that he wants to be an ass and kill me. Take that guy out really quick. Yeet. Alright. There's an item down there, but we don't get to it until... Alright, I guess we could drop down over here and get to it, but I want to get to that guy up there. So let's get this item really quick first, though. Gaichan Sugar. Alright. Yeah, this game makes you so fast. You're pretty much like the fastest person in this game is you. So you gotta use that and everything else to your advantage. Alright, let's see, guy. I want to buy these light coin purses from him. Maybe his pellets.
May the departed.
Heck. Oh, that would cost me a little bit of health. I've got too much money. And if I die, that means... Alright, well, I can do this. Heck it. Heck it all. I can do it. I believe in myself. Is there anything up here? Oh, okay. I'm just checking. Grab that. Spirit emblem. Alright. Now, if you jump up here, and you do this crouch, you can eavesdrop.
Big bastard just tied up next to us. I think we'll not be gravely injured just before the war begins.
If the worst happens, only choice is to use those that are feared by it. That's what the Lord's proclamation says.
Proclamation? You joke.
Fire. That's why I went and got the flame barrel. Best guy to kill is this guy right here, because the other guy is just easy to take care of. You just stab attack him. Alright. If If we could sneak around somehow. Let me make sure I got the floor bent. Oh shit, here we go. He already noticed me. That looked too easy. I've only got two more flame attacks though, so I gotta use them very sparingly. Oh, that was close. Kill me. Oh no. Oh, I got him. Look at my health, guys. Look at my health. Oh. Oh. Alright, let's not get killed by this dude right here. Shinobi Medicine Rank 1. Latent skill that increases healing effect of recovery items. Medicinal knowledge is vital for Shinobi's survival. Receiving wounds in battle is inevitable. The only way to learn such techniques is to be gravely injured time and time again by worthy opponents. Alright, I'm gonna turn this down just a smidgen. Here we go. There's a guy coming after me right now. I just need to heal really quick. He's really easy to take out, but if he would have killed me, I'd have been mad. Alright. There's an item over there. There's a way to get over there. I'll show you guys all that. Just let me grab this item. Let's see where I'm at in my stream really quick. 32 minutes. Alright.